So hi everyone, a very good evening to all of you and welcome back once again to another class of PIB 247. In today's class, we'll be talking about the PIB news from 17th and 18th of April 2024. But before we begin, please give me a thumbs up if you can see me properly and can hear me properly. And today we are going to cover two very important reports which are very important from the exam point of view. So very good evening everyone, please give me a thumbs up if everything is fine, if you can see me properly and can hear me properly, if the voice is clear. Very very good evening sabhi logo ko. Yes, so I have a lot of thumbs up. Let's wait for 20 more seconds so that other people can also join, so that we can start with the class. Okay, very good evening everyone. I hope my voice is clear. So let's start with the very first question for the day. Question number one says, the Ministry of Finance has recently notified amended rules under FEMA 1999 to operationalize its earlier decisions to allow up to 100% FDI for the space sector through three categories of liberalized entry routes. This news we have discussed few weeks back, right? But finally, the notification regarding the amendment has been done, has been released. So that is why we are discussing it again. Okay. Under these amended rules, for which space activity 100% FDI is allowed under the automatic route? That is a very, very important question. Okay. So the Ministry of Finance, the news is this only, that the Ministry of Finance, headed by Nirmala Sitharaman, as of now, has notified the amended rules under the Foreign Exchange Management Act. And why this amendment has been done? This amendment has been done so that the government could operationalize its earlier decisions. And what was that earlier decision? Allowing up to 100% FDI for the space sector through three categories of liberalized entry routes. ठीक है, तो क्या क्या चीजें इसके अंदर हुई है इसके बारे में बात कर लेते हैं एक बार और. हमने कुछ समय पहले ही पढ़ा था. Now the new rules are called as Foreign Exchange Management Non-Debt Instrument Third Amendment Rules 2024, and the rules which have been amended are known as Foreign Exchange Management Non-Debt Instrument Rules 2019. Right, and I hope guys you remember that in India, FDI is governed by the FDI policy that is announced by the government of India, and under which act the FDI policy is announced. This is something which is very important that you should know. The FDI policy is announced under the provisions of FEMA 1999, Foreign Exchange Management Act. Right. And under the amended policy related to the space sector, the government, the Union Cabinet, the government of India has allowed 100% FDI through both automatic and government routes. Now, in some spaces, in some areas, 100% automatic route is allowed, while in some areas, some percentage is allowed through the automatic route, while some percentage is allowed through the government route. Now, what is the meaning of automatic route? In automatic route, the investor will not have to take the permission from the government of India or from RBI. While if the investment is done through the government route, then in that case, permission from the government of India will have to be taken. All right. And this policy is in line with the strategy under Indian Space Policy of 2023. Before this, FDI was there, but it was only for establishing and operating satellites, and that too only through the government's approval route. Right. Keval government approval route ke through hi FDI allowed tha space sector mein, and that too only in the area of establishing and operating the satellites. Iske alawa kahin pe bhi nahi tha, right? But now they have opened it up, and bahut sari space activities mein the government has allowed the FDI. Now, number one, satellites manufacturing and operation, satellite data products, ground segment and user segment. Isme FDI ki maximum cap 100% hai obviously, and up to 74% can be done. Investment in these three areas can be done up to 74% through the automatic route. But if the investment goes beyond 74% of the project cost, then in that case, the government's approval is required. Same is the case with these two activities. Number one, launch vehicles and associated systems or subsystems, creation of spaceports for launching and receiving spacecraft. In this, 49% investment can be done through the automatic route, while if the investment will go beyond 49%, then governments or RBI approval is required, right? And last, manufacturing of components and systems or subsystems for satellites, ground segment and user segment. In this, 100% automatic route, 100% investment through automatic route has been allowed now. All right. I hope it is clear. So these are the amendments. Now let's identify under which space activity 100% FDI is allowed. So satellite manufacturing and operation is 74%. Satellite data products, no. Manufacturing of components and subsystems for satellites, yes. In this activity, 100% FDI is allowed under the automatic route, and that was the question. So option C is the right answer, guys, to this question. I hope it is clear. Now let's talk about question number two. This is about a report, very very important. You need to identify the incorrect statement about recently released trade and development report update of April 2024. Now this report has been released by UNCTAD. Do remember this as well. And what is UNCTAD, by the way? United Nations Conference on Trade and Development. Right, United Nations Conference on Trade and Development. This organization has released trade and development report for the month of April 2024. Now all the updates are very recent in this particular report. Okay, so what are the highlights of this report? Number one, regarding global economic growth, this report has not provided us a very, you know, kuch bahut acche sanket isne nahi diye, right? This report says that the global economy to grow to 2.6%, just 2.6% in 2024, which is barely above the 2.5 threshold. And what is this threshold for? It is threshold for the recessionary phase, right? If the global economy goes, if the growth of global economy goes below 2.5% or 2.5%, then that is a situation of recession in the global world, in the world, right? So the global economy will grow only by 2.6%, which is, you know, just above the threshold of recessionary phase. Yeah. This rate also signifies the third consecutive year of growth below the pre-pandemic average of 3.2% from 2015 to 19. So in the pre-pandemic period, the global economy was growing at the rate of more than 3%. But since then, the global economy is not growing at that level, right? And India's economy ke baare mein ye report kafi, you know, optimistic hai. And it says that buoyed by strong public investment and service sector growth, India's economy will grow by 6.5% in 2024. Kyunki hamare desh mein is samay service sector boom kar raha hai, and the private investments are going on because the government of India has opened up the economy more and more. Right, so due to more and more private investments, India's economy will grow by 6.5% against just 2.6% growth in the global economy. Now, global trade ke baare mein ye report ye kehti hai that in 2023, in the last year, global merchandise trade fell by about 1% in real terms. Right, and obviously, when global merchandise trade will fall, then what will happen? It will have a definite, it will have a significant impact on the global economic growth. Because agar global merchandise trade achche se kaam nahi karega, then obviously it will create a dent on the global economic growth. And why the global merchandise trade fell by 1%? What are the reasons? So the two reasons which have been highlighted by this report are, number one, due to trade tensions among some large economies. Like, for example, the trade tensions are going on between USA and China. Very recently, USA increased the tariffs for the goods of China, right? The trade tensions going on between China and Australia. So obviously, whenever there is a trade tension between such large economies, definitely it will impact the global economy, right? And the second reason that it has highlighted is the disruptions in the key shipping route. Abhi, very recently in the month of February 2024, USCTAD came out with a report which was titled as Navigating Troubled Waters is the report that was released recently by UNCTAD. In this report, UNCTAD highlighted that the shipping route of Red Sea, the shipping route of Red Sea, Black Sea, and Panama Canal, these are getting disrupted. Now, why these are getting disrupted? Due to climate change, number one, and due to the war going on between Russia and Ukraine, right? Now, this will have a very huge impact on the global economy because 80% of the transportation of goods is being done through these routes. And Red Sea is also very important. The route of Red Sea is very important because it connects Suez Canal. It connects Indian Ocean to Suez Canal and Mediterranean Sea. Right. So there is a disruption in the key shipping routes and result, and as a result of that, there was 1% fell. There was 1% decline in the global merchandise trade. You can see, I hope it is clear. Now let's move ahead. Now, this report talks about the debt dynamics in developing countries. Okay, so number one, high debt burden is draining valuable public resources from the developing countries. The money which could have otherwise be used for the welfare purpose or for the economy or for the growth of the economy is being used for servicing the debt, is being used for paying off the debt, right? So the public resources are being used from these developing countries for servicing their debts. Number one. Number two, high global interest rates have worsened these challenges, right? With currency depreciation making foreign denominated debt more costly. Now, at the global level, interest rates are going up. And when the global interest rate will increase, what will happen? The domestic currency of such a developing country shall depreciate. Currency kya hogi? Depreciate ho jayegi. Aur ab jab currency depreciate ho jayegi, then what will happen? Theek hai, maan lete hain ki aaj $1.80 ka hai, kal ko wo $1.100 ka ho jayega. Then what will happen? India will need more dollars to pay off its debt, to pay its import bills, to pay its every liability which it has to pay in the dollar, right? And by 2023, this report says that 9 low income countries had fallen into the debt distress, and with an additional 25 such developing countries are on the brink of falling into the debt trap, right? So kafi durdasha hai developing countries ki. Now this report also says this report also talks about the monetary policy impact on developing economies. Number one, higher debt servicing costs and difficulty in securing new financing options. Ab already agar koi country debt trap pe fasa hua hai, then no organization or no country will take a risk to further lend to such country. ठीक है, हाई डेट सर्विसिंग कॉस्ट है, ये मैंने आपको ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन कर दिया. नंबर वन. नंबर टू, इंक्रीज इन द इंटरेस्ट रेट्स इन द डेवलप्ड वर्ल्ड, डेप्रिसिएशन डेवलपिंग वर्ल्ड करेंसीज. सो आप जितनी मर्जी मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी बना लो, जितनी मर्जी मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी टाइट कर लो या लूज कर लो, कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ने वाला, बिकॉज योर करेंसी इज डेप्रिशिएटेड, राइट? लास्ट, डबल डिजिट इंटरेस्ट रेट्स बाय सेंट्रल बैंक ऑफ मेनी डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज हैड एन एडवर्स इंपैक्ट ऑन डोमेस्टिक डिमांड, employment and household income. Agar hamare desh mein loan ka interest rate bahut zyada badh jayega, then what will happen? The manufacturers will not get motivated, right, to take loan from the banks. This will lead to decrease in production and hence the employment, and hence it will be a huge dent on the economic growth, right? So interest rates ka kafi bada role hai. Now commodity markets remain volatile despite falling by 6.8% in 2023. Commodity prices remain significantly higher than the pre-pandemic levels, right? The energy sector saw the largest price drop at 16.1%, yet prices are still about 40% higher than the averages between 2015 and 2019. these increased prices have benefited exporters but have heavily burdened net commodity importing developing countries. अब इससे exporters को तो benefit मिला, right? इन prices के बढ़ने से exporters को तो benefit मिल जाएगा. But what about those countries which are importing these products with elevated prices? उनके लिए तो burden हो जाएगा ना भाई. Developing countries already debt burden में है, debt trap पे फंसी हुई है. And now the prices are, you know, increasing. You know, अगर जनरल प्राइस लेवल पूरी दुनिया में इंक्रीज हो रहा है, पूरी दुनिया में इन्फ्लेशन है, तो क्या होगा? इन डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज की और ज्यादा दुर्दशा हो जाएगी. सो दिस इज व्हाट दिस स्लाइड इज टॉकिंग अबाउट, राइट? आई होप इट इज क्लियर, द रिपोर्ट इज क्लियर. नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. लेट्स आइडेंटिफाई द इनकरेक्ट स्टेटमेंट. ग्लोबल इकोनॉमी टू ग्रो टू 2.6% इन 2024, बेयरली अबव द 2.5% थ्रेशोल्ड एसोसिएटेड विद द रिसेशनरी फेज. दिस इज एब्सोल्युटली करेक्ट. In 2023, global merchandise trade fell by about 4%. No, it fell by about 1%. So option B is the incorrect statement, which means option B is the right answer. ठीक है जी, I hope it is clear. If yes, please give me a thumbs up. And now let's come to another report, which is World Population 2024 report. Very, very important social issue. Population is one of the major issue for country like India. Now we have the largest population. We have surpassed the China. ठीक है ना? और इतने कम जगह में इतने सारे लोग रह रहे हैं, इतने limited resources में we are catering to a huge population. So which of the following statements are incorrect about the recently released State of World Population 2024 report? And it has been released by United Nation Population Fund. ठीक है, so बात करते हैं. It is an annual report published by United Nation Population Fund, and in every edition it analyzes the developments and trends in the world population and demographics. पूरी दुनिया के population में और demography में क्या क्या changes आए हैं, ये उसको analyze करता है. कैसे वो changes helpful होंगे, कैसे वो changes helpful नहीं होंगे, everything is being analyzed every year through this report by United Nation Population Fund, right? It also shed light on specific regions, countries and population groups and the unique challenges that these regions or countries or population face. Now what is the theme? Interwoven lives, threads of hope, ending inequalities in sexual and reproductive health and rights. Women's sexual and reproductive health and rights include the right to be free from torture, right? If anyone asks you that what do you mean by women's sexual and reproductive health and rights, so in that case you can answer that person, it means right to be free from torture. Like we could see in Afghanistan and we could see the domestic violence in our country as well, aapke aas pados mein sab jagah. The right to health, the right to privacy, the right to education, the right to life and protection against discrimination. So all these are the women's sexual and reproductive health and rights, right? Now this report says that India leads globally with an estimated population of more than 144 crores, followed by China. India's population was recorded at 121 crores, as you all know, during the first census. And do you know, this report also says that in the next 77 years, India's population will become double. दुगनी हो जाएगी अगले 77 सालों में. What is the age wise group distribution in the country? 68% of India's population belongs to the age group of 15 to 64 years, which is approximately the working age population. This is something which is a very good thing about India. And when we will lose this demography anywhere around 2050, then उस समय इंडिया की दुर्दशा होनी शुरू होगी. ठीक है, अभी तो हम बहुत अच्छे फेज में चल रहे हैं, बहुत बढ़िया दौर चल रहा है इस समय इंडिया के लिए. 26% ऑफ द पॉपुलेशन बिलोंग्स टू 10 टू 24 इयर्स ऑफ एज ग्रुप, 17% इज विद इन 10 टू 19 इयर्स ऑफ एज ग्रुप, 24% ऑफ इंडियाज पॉपुलेशन इज एज्ड 0 टू 14 एंड 7% जस्ट 7% ऑफ इंडियाज पॉपुलेशन इज एज्ड 65 इयर्स एंड अबव. और 2050 में ये परसेंटेज बढ़ने वाला है. Non-working age population, the dependent population is going to be increased in 2050, right? And that is a very major concern for a country like India. अगर हम develop नहीं हो पाए तब तक developing ही रह गए, So that will be a huge problem for us. Now you don't have to remember all these groups. ठीक है, इतने सारे percentages आपको याद रखने की जरूरत नहीं है. This report says that India's total fertility rate is estimated at 2.0. Life expectancy at birth. For men it is 71 years. For women it is 74 years. Right? And what is the child marriage rates in India between the period of 2006 to 2023? In those around 15 years, 15 to 16 jitne bhi hai, itne saalon mein 23% was the child marriage rates, which means if 100 marriages happened in this period, out of these 100 marriages, 23 marriages were the child marriages. Okay? मैटर्नल डेथ के बारे में इसने कुछ बताया है हमारे रिपोर्ट में. सो दे हैव फॉलन कंसिडरेबली अकाउंटिंग फॉर 8% ऑफ ऑल सच फैटलिटीज वर्ल्ड वाइड. राइट, एंड दैट इज दिस सक्सेस इज एट्रिब्यूटेड टू अ लॉट ऑफ इनिशिएटिव्स एंड गवर्नमेंट स्कीम्स व्हिच आर बीइंग इंप्लीमेंटेड बाय द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया. लाइक वी हैव सुमन, लाइक वी हैव जननी सुरक्षा योजना, लाइक वी हैव जननी शिशु सुरक्षा कार्यक्रम, लाइक वी हैव लक्ष्य, लाइक वी हैव मा, लाइक वी हैव प्रधानमंत्री मातृ वंदना योजना, लाइक वी हैव आयुष्मान भारत योजना. हाउएवर इट स्टिल कंटिन्यूज टू सी ड्रामेटिक इनइक्विटीज इन मैटरनल डेथ रिस्क. ठीक है, कहीं जगहों पे बहुत ज्यादा है, कहीं जगहों पे बहुत कम है. राइट, नाउ दिस रिपोर्ट हैज कोटेड अ रिपोर्ट एस्टिमेट्स एंड कोरिलेट्स ऑफ डिस्ट्रिक्ट लेवल एमएमआर इन इंडिया, एंड दैट वाज दिस रिपोर्ट वाज रिलीज बाय पीएलओएस ग्लोबल पब्लिक हेल्थ. ठीक है, और इस रिपोर्ट का हवाला देते हुए यूएनएफपीए ने बताया है दैट द पीएलओएस कंडक्टेड रिसर्च इन इंडिया 640 डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स एंड डेटा इज लाइक दिस. 1/3 ऑफ द डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स हैव अचीव्ड द सस्टेनेबल डेवलपमेंट गोल ऑफ रिड्यूसिंग एमएमआर बिलो 70 पर 1 लाख लाइव बर्थ्स. मैटर्नल मोर्टिलिटी रेशियो, फॉर दोज हु डोंट नो एमएमआर इज मैटर्नल मोर्टिलिटी रेशियो, मैटर्नल डेथ्स पर 1 लाख लाइव बर्थ्स. Maternal deaths per 1 lakh live births is the meaning of MMR. Okay, in a given period, of course. 114 districts still have an MMR of 210 or more. Okay, so that is why we were talking about inequities, right? And the highest MMR, that is 1671 per 1 lakh births, was seen in Tirap district of Arunachal Pradesh. 1671 maternal deaths per like per 1 lakh live births. So you can imagine the situation of Tirap district of Arunachal Pradesh. Right? Very heinous situation. So that's it about this report, guys. I hope it is clear. Now let's identify the incorrect statement. Its title or theme was Unleashing the Power of Gender Equality. No, it is not the title. India leads globally with an estimated population of 144.7 crores, followed by China. Absolutely correct. 68% of India's population belongs to the age group of not 15 to 45 but 15 to 64. So this is incorrect. India's TFR is estimated not at 1.5 but at 2.0. This is also incorrect. In India, life expectancy at birth is estimated at 74 years and 71 for men and women respectively. It is reversibly written. It is 71 years for women and 71 years for men. And 74 years for women. So this is also incorrect, which means the correct answer will be option A, 1, 3, 4, and 5 only. Alright. Okay, guys, now let's talk about the questions in short. But before that, if you want to have the PDF of this class, you can join the Telegram channel. The link is in the description. Question number 5. Which PSU has opened its office in GIFT City, Gandhinagar, of course, to provide debt options denominated in foreign currencies to boost green hydrogen and renewable energy manufacturing projects? The PSU in question, guys, is IREDA, Indian Renewable Energy Development Agency. Option B is the right answer. Where has DRDO, Defense Research Development Organization, set up state-of-the-art space? What is space? Submersible platform for acoustic characterization and evaluation. We need not go into the details of space at all. Right, it is a premier testing and evaluation hub for sonar systems for the Indian Navy, and Indian Navy has now the new chief. Can you tell me the name of the new chief of Indian Navy? Let's see who have this information. The right answer to this question is Kerala. The right answer is answer to this question is Kerala. And the last question for today, with which IIT has the Armed Forces Medical Services recently signed an MOU to conduct collaborative research and training to address health problems being faced by soldiers in difficult terrains? Very important question, directly related to the social issue. The right answer is IIT Kanpur, located in Uttar Pradesh. Option E is the right answer. All right, guys, so now that's it. Yes. Yes. Admiral Dinesh Tripathi is now the new chief of Indian Navy. Very well done, guys. Tell you now, if you have any doubts, you can ask me. Or otherwise, give me your thumbs up if everything is fine. चलिए जी, बताइए कोई डाउट है, कोई दिक्कत, कोई समस्या, सो यू गाइस कैन आस्क मी. I think there are no doubts. Okay, so let's wind it up. I'll see you in the next class on Monday. Till then, keep studying and keep studying hard. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.